I'm Steve.
I'm Stella.
And we're the Swannies Down Under.
Cheers, cup of coffee.
Cheers, some coffee, yeah.
Wet hair.
What have we got today then? What have we got to tell you today?
Today's Monday, 9 o'clock in the morning. And we've had a fairly busy weekend, so we didn't get a chance to do it yesterday because it was Father's Day. So it was busy all day.
Counting down.
Moving out.
We've got 13 days to go.
13 days before we move out, which is very exciting. Yes. Can't wait.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's all going.
So,
we're still waiting.
Sorry.
But we're still waiting. We haven't got long to wait now, so that's good.
Yeah, we're actually moving out in 13 days, but our completion date's a little bit after that. So we can make sure that it's nice and clean for our new owner.
I did pull a few weeds out of the front garden yesterday.
Yes, that's the few. Our black settee went on Saturday. Mm-hmm. We got our table and chairs is going on sometime this week. We've got our bed is going on at the weekend.
So
we've only got about 6 more sleeps in our bed and then we'll be on the camp bed.
Yeah. Only for a week though.
What else happened over the weekend?
And this is going?
This settee and the TV is going.
So if it feels more echoey, that's because there's less furniture.
Echoey?
We're nearly
in an empty house. We've got a fridge, freezer can go at the last minute with the bike. If you're wondering why we're called RV Living, the Swannies Down Under, it's mainly because most of our videos are going to be living in an RV. I know this is video number 25, and so they've all been about just downsizing and what we feel like. But
so what number would be the first one in the RV, do you think? 28?
Yeah, somewhere around there.
28, 29.
So if you want to skip a few, don't do it.
Anyway, yeah, so.
Again.
We were talking yesterday about bucket lists, and I was asking my sister what hers was, and she said a few things. And I realised that on my bucket list, which I'd forgotten about, was actually to one day live in a caravan. And I realised that was quite a revelation, because it was like, wow, this was on my bucket list to do years ago, that a dream that you forget about. So I don't know, it's kind of made me realise that this is what I've always wanted to do, even years and years ago when we had a caravan before. I always wanted to kind of challenge myself to live with less and see if I could be okay, as happy, even happier. So that's the challenge that I think I really want to challenge myself with. Can I be as happy with less? Or will I be miserable because I haven't got a bigger house? Or, you know, will I be dissatisfied? I'm really keen to find out, because I see everyone else do it and they all seem a bit happier. unless obviously
their
breakdowns, but
they're on freedom.
Yeah, exactly. They haven't got the constraints of mortgages and being tied to one place. And you know, we take the dog out for a walk and we're like, yeah, we're done here, we need to move on and see something new. And so it'll be interesting.
I think we need a bit more going on in our life, and that's going to happen in
apart
starting,
from work,
yeah,
and clean
and do the gardening, yeah. And it's just, you know, and you're paying
pay bills,
all this money just to have space around you,
yeah.
Really, that is private.
And I think,
and you don't see people, like we walk around the streets, walking the dog, and everyone's tucked away here in Australia, you know.
Behind their houses, but they're not.
You know, if you live around like-minded people, that's good for your health, your mental health, I think.
Yeah, and whenever we've been to a caravan park, people always seem really, really friendly and chatty.
Yeah.
And, you know, and I suppose I'm talking about the people that actually do more, not families with kids, because they're usually there on holiday. I think that's a bit different, but I think we always go out of season, so we have been.
Ooh.
So, but it's that challenge of, and when we went in the tent for a week and we had this little tent and we just absolutely were like pigs in crap, weren't we, really? It was interesting because we were quite I don't know, it was the simple things. So
living really simply appeals to us.
What, because, you know, how you do everything is how you do anything. So what are you really looking forward to in terms of what changes do you think you'll be making?
Change? I'm probably changing my hobbies. So I'm going to get a drone and start doing, giving you some good pictures. I'm going to really get into that. A lot of people just seem to show 2 or 3 minutes.
Maybe that's a long time.
I don't know, but I want to be
that's a long time.
Able to fly this thing and then start showing you some different interesting views of where we are, you know, where we've gone, where we're going. So,
so in terms of lifestyle, there's your hobbies.
Lifestyle, cleaner, everything.
Do you think you'll eat less and drink less? Is that what you're saying?
I think I will, actually. I think my eating habits and my drink, especially my drinking's got to change. But, and I'm looking forward to that. I mean, 6 months ago when we started doing this, I was a lot slimmer. I think I have,
We don't go to pubs and things. We tend to, it's too expensive.
Oh, no, it's too expensive. Pubs here, oh my gosh. They don't talk to you at the bar.
Well, that's because you had a pub and you're a... That was different, back in England, I think it's different. Even now it's changed though in England, you know, you don't get that private ownership so much, so a whole landlord thing.
Mm.
What else have you been doing?
Healthy eating's going to be good.
What else?
I'm looking forward to the whole thing and it's getting really more...
Steve's been very busy, he's been doing everything, he's been organising PO boxes.
I've got a PO box address.
Yeah, all the bills.
The conveyancing... Put all the conveyancing forms
the
through this weekend. Just organised an appointment with the conveyancer because he needs to see us in the flesh with our passports and our driver's licences. So that's happening on Wednesday. What else have we done? Cleaned the garage out, sold a few more bits.
You emptied the shed completely, didn't you?
Completely cleared the shed out. The swimming pool's clean again, clean and blue. I've been doing that a bit every night. We're nearly there, actually. I feel like it's gone really smoothly. I feel a bit... How do I feel about...
Smug.
Not smug, but a lot of people that you watch on these videos, they say, like, oh, it's really, really hectic. I think the only time that we thought it was a bit stressful was when we was actually selling and having to clean...
Steve, you've got a very short memory, I reckon. That was stressful.
It was stressful.
Yeah, when you look back, in hindsight
saying.
Though, yeah, it didn't
But this
go.
Bit hasn't been that stressful, has
no,
it?
No, this bit, what, selling stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah, this bit hasn't, no. But it's still a pain in the butt.
I think the wind down to actually leaving and selling stuff on the way has made it not so...
Is that because you've been coping by drinking a lot?
That is a possibility.
Yeah, that was your coping mechanism.
Not sure if it's right, but it's a possibility.
Keep eating and drinking. To cope with the stress.
To live. You've got enough wood left for one more fire. That's it. Literally.
So
I've got a bit of kindling wood and 3 logs.
It's not going to be that. It's the temperature's warming up. It's a bit more rainy and windy, but it's warming up, so probably won't need it.
I'm going to use it.
But we can always take the wood and put it in the storage. Anyway, if we had a bag left, if we wanted to buy a bag.
So yeah, not long to go, guys.
Not long to go. We're excited. Oh my gosh. And I've been using my dream pot a lot. Very impressed with that. Sussed it out.
Now she's got the name right.
Used it quite a few times. So yeah, there's a few things that I would really... Oh, they don't have a literage on the inside of the pot, so that's a bit of a pain.
You could work it out yourself.
Yeah, but I'd want to put a little scratch on it so I could tell. Because
I could do that for you.
You know, simple things like that sometimes. These companies, they don't really think of those things. But I mean, for... Put 2 litres in, we'll save you, you know, measuring it out. Just put a little blooming marker on the inside of the pot. I mean,
how long does it take to measure it out?
Yeah, no, but it's these little things, you know, everything little helps, doesn't it? Okay, here we are. Ready to unveil the pot. Ooh, that's some hats. Good. Mmm. What it'll taste like. smiles when you're having fun.
It does.
Yeah, I've got to go drama here. I'm going to go see my lovely friend. And yeah, it's not been a good week. Well, it's not been a great week. One of my friends is very, very unwell. That's been the challenge. It's been difficult at work this week. So it's not been the best week for me, but hey, it's life, hey. It's not always sunshine and lollipops. But it's another week. Hopefully this week will be better.
Okay, then, we're on that note, we'll say cheers, guys.
Have a lovely day.
Adios, amigos.
Be kind to yourselves and everyone else, because life's too short.